In this video, I'd like to take a closer look at PP and PPCF filament. This exciting material promises not only good mechanical properties, but also a number of other special features such as being food safe and the fact that it doesn't absorb any moisture from the air. In addition, it is very easy to print at home. I have performed all my mechanical tests and I am convinced that this is one of the most underrated filaments. So stay tuned here at Jantec Engineering. Polypropylene, or PP for short, is one of the most widely produced plastics in the world. This is partly due to its good mechanical, thermal and chemical properties. It is also considered skin friendly and is used in the pharma and food industries. A lot of packaging is made from PP. In Europe, this can be recognized by the recycling symbol with the number 5. Nevertheless, this material has a rather poor reputation when it comes to 3D printing, especially in the personal sector. This is because PP basically only sticks to itself, making standard PI or glass printing surfaces unsuitable. And yes, I have tried to print PP on such a smooth Prusa PI plate, there's no chance. Years ago, hobbyists started to recommend sticking packaging tape onto the print bed, as this is usually made of PP. I have also tried this, the material itself adheres perfectly, but this is where the second disadvantage comes into play, namely the tendency to warp. These warping forces are stronger than the adhesive of the tape, and depending on the size and surface of the component, this can lead to deformation or the complete failure of the print. That's why I was really happy when I learned that the company PPprint deals with precisely this topic. They offer an all-round package that includes PP filament optimized for 3D printing, as well as specially developed print bed surfaces to which the material should adhere perfectly. There are also suitable care products. As for the filament, PPprint currently offers 3 different types, all of which are compatible with each other. This means that they adhere to one another and can therefore be combined using multi-material printing. On the one hand, there's classic PP called P-filament 721 in various colors, as well as natural black and white. There's also PP with carbon fiber, CF for short, reinforcement, called P-filament carbon 411, which promises additional exciting properties that we'll look at in a moment. For more professional applications, there is also PP support material that is compatible with the other two PP filaments and can then be removed from the component using heat. However, to be able to use the support material properly, you need a dual extruder or tool changer. The very friendly team behind PPprint was kind enough to send me a selection of their products so that I could test them for you. To be more precise, there is regular PP in red and black, as well as PPCF, which is also black due to the dark fibers. We also have two print bed surfaces. One is the premium piece surface for Prusa MK3 and MK4, and the other is the stick-on version. This also includes the required adhesive and tools, a cutter, roller and such a card. This allows the surface to be applied to any print sheet. Various sizes are available in the PP print shop. There is also this cleaning set, which can be used to remove dirt from the sheets. But now let's move on to printing with these materials. I started with the regular PP in red on my Prusa MK4. I placed the premium piece surface sheet on the heatbed, entered the temperature settings in the Prusa slicer and started the first print. To be honest, I have to admit that I initially had doubts as to whether the print would really adhere well and whether the quality would be right. However, these doubts were completely gone after this almost perfect banshee. Removing it from the print bed by heating it up to 120 degrees Celsius also worked perfectly. I then printed out all the samples for the tests right away. Next came the PPCF, for which I first had to install a hardened nozzle in the Prusa, as the fibers are abrasive and the standard brass nozzle would have been destroyed pretty quick. I therefore installed an E3D Obsidian V6 nozzle with a suitable adapter. I then simply increased the temperature in the slicer by 15 degrees Celsius and I was ready to print. I have no complaints about this material either, quite the opposite. Another nice advantage of the carbon fibers is that small flaws and layer transitions are like blurred by the fibers, resulting in a very nice, smooth looking surface. Once all the specimens had been printed, I wanted to print a larger sample object and opted for these exhaust pipes from Printables. This print also turned out perfectly. By the way, the component weighs just 52 grams, which is due to the low density of PP. I will go into the exact values later. But first, let's take a look at the mechanical properties which I determined using the test equipment I built myself. The tensile test can be used to analyze two interesting properties. Firstly, the strength of the material, meaning how well it can withstand tensile forces directed outwards. In the following, this is referred as the tensile strength in the XY direction. On the other hand, the layer adhesion can be analyzed, in other words, how well the individual layers stacked during printing bond to each other. This is then referred to as the tensile strength in the Z direction. For the tests, I printed 4 of these samples in a lying position and 4 in standing position. I then pulled them apart with my tensile test, measured the fracture surface and recorded all the measurements in an Excel spreadsheet. The tensile strength in megapascals, that is tensile force per area, is then automatically calculated. Here you can see the results of the regular red PP and the PPCF. While the tensile strength in the XY direction of the PPCF is slightly better than that of the normal PP, the layer adhesion is completely different. At 23.8 megapascals, the tensile strength in the Z direction is over 60% higher than that of the carbon PP. A comparison with other materials such as ABS or ASA shows that the layer adhesion of PP stands out. Now let's move on to the next test, my 3-point bending experiment. This can be used to determine the bending modulus as a measure of the stiffness of the materials. To do this, I printed out bending beams from both materials. In the test setup, these are weighted over a ring, which exerts force on the center of the sample. From the top, a dial indicator can then be used to measure how far the sample bends. Then we can calculate the bending modulus in megapascals. The higher this value, the stiffer the material. The comparison shows that regular PP is not really stiff. The carbon fiber version, on the other hand, is quite different as the material is reinforced by the fibers. Specifically, I calculated a bending modulus of 566 megapascals for the PP. The bending modulus of the PPCF is more than 8 times higher at around 4803 megapascals. This huge difference is also noticeable when bending the samples by hand. Here is the comparison with other common filaments. The toughness of the material can be analyzed using an impact test. It is relevant for impact-like loads. A good example here is a quadcopter frame, which also crashes occasionally. Standard materials such as PLA or PETG are not really impact resistant. PP, on the other hand, is. The test shows that at 10 kJ per square meter, PP has twice the impact strength of normal PLA, which can be very helpful to some applications. Now to the temperature test, in which I analyze the temperatures at which printed samples can be deformed. It is important to know this point, especially when the finished components are exposed to heat. For this, I used the bending beam from the 3-point bending test, only with 30% gyroid infill, to represent a realistic component. Then I placed the samples on two profiles 100 mm apart and weighed them down in the center with nuts of about 9 grams. The whole thing then goes into the oven, which heats up to circulating air. The point at which the samples become soft and buckle under the weights of the nuts is then recorded. It turns out that PP is quite temperature resistant, even though it does not have to be printed particularly hot. The temperature resistance is roughly comparable to that of glass fiber ABS, and with PPCF it's even slightly higher. The normal red PP becomes soft at just under 100 degrees Celsius and then buckles at 120 degrees Celsius. The PPCF range is shifted by approximately 20 degrees, it's softened at 120 degrees Celsius and then buckled at around 140 to 150 degrees Celsius. Now let's take a look at a few more properties and possible applications for PP. The material has a very low density and is therefore one of the lightest plastics. A density of 0.9 grams per cubic centimeter is specified for PPprint's PP. For comparison, PLA has a density of around 1.25 grams per cubic centimeter and PETG has a density of 1.38 grams per cubic centimeter, which is around 65% higher than that of PP. This makes polypropylene perfect for lightweight components, which are often required in aero modeling. In addition, PP is considered food safe, which means that it's approved for contact with food. However, you have to be careful as contaminants can get into the parts during printing, for example due to leftovers in the nozzle. In addition, 3D printed components are almost impossible to clean properly as the small gaps between the layers provide space for bacteria and are almost impossible to remove. Here you can see a macro shot of a sample from the Tensile Test I did with Stefan during my internship at CNC Kitchen. It shows that even if the component looks smooth from the outside, there are still gaps between the layers. Nevertheless, PP can be cleaned in the dishwasher. This is partly due to its chemical and temperature resistance. Details must therefore be considered for each application and if necessary analyzed with professional tests. One specific example application that comes to mind with regard to dishwasher compatibility would be spare parts for the dishwasher itself, such as the rollers or handles. Another exciting property is chemical resistance. A few years ago, for example, I had a project that involved printing a connecting tube for a hydrogen peroxide supply. The requirements for the tube were chemical resistance on the one hand and sufficient strength on the other, as the tube was attached at two ends and therefore tensile forces acted in basically all directions. The second requirement led to the failure of the project, as the prototypes made of PLA and ASA broke. The weak point was the layer adhesion. Looking back, I'm pretty sure that this pipe would work with PP, which is why I gave it a try and printed it out. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If so, I'd be very happy about a like, subscription and comment. Thanks for watching and see you next time at Jantec Engineering.